Okay, here we go. So, yeah, running late this week, so I'm going to make this really short, sweet, and complete, and going to save, actually, going to save all the updates that I had set up here for next time. And I want to talk about, well, just to mention, when you're getting involved in the NetLab stuff, there may be things that don't work. And if you've seen the NetLab video, you'll have seen that I mentioned to you sort of, you know, when good NetLabs go bad, what are some of the tips and tricks that you shut down and then start again some of the virtual machines? Or I've had to, worst case, is actually just quit out of the entire reservation and make a new reservation. Sometimes stuff doesn't work. That's called science. And then what do you do? You know, that's the deal. So ethical hacking, pen testing laws and standards, footprinting are the jobs for this time. And again, same thing, take the test, get 70% or better, and your points are predicated on the percentage you get, but minimum 70%, because you can take it over and over again, and it's not that hard. But this is really going to set the stage for two things. When we're discussing pen testing, the process of it, what are the laws and standards that we have for us here for penetration testing? We're going to be doing some things in the next couple of weeks where we're talking about the Project Management Book of Knowledge, where we're talking about the process of planning and performing a penetration test, or assessing assets and assessing risks, and then deciding on mitigations, which is part of our process as cybersecurity professionals. And then the footprinting, which is going to set the stage for your next NetLab, which is going to be doing footprinting there in NetLab. So those are the two things doing this week. This is a great link to something that happened, well, a couple of years ago, but these two guys that got arrested doing a penetration test, make sure to carry a copy of your contract with you and make sure you have permission to do what it is you think you're actually permitted to do, because these guys spent several months in jail. Okay, so I'll spoiler alert here. If I recall correctly, it was the state that decided the county court system was not secure. So they hired these guys to do a penetration test of the county courthouse. But they got caught. And then it was a political fight between the county and the state. So these guys got stuck. They were actually out of state. They were from a different state. They got stuck in jail for a while the county and the Dallas County Courthouse and the judicial branch and all those folks tried to figure out their stuff before they actually got let out. They didn't have a copy of the signed contract with them when they were doing that. So there's a reason why we understand what are the laws and standards and the value of a contract and the value of very clearly specifying what it is we're doing and specifically how we're going to be going about doing that when we're doing penetration testing, red team stuff. So very cool. Yeah, and then the heads up, because we're going to be using GAN Project, CMAP tools, and you've got NetScan tools in there. You could go ahead and do that. I meant this year to, let me just put this. Optional right now is to go get NetScan Tools Pro, the free edition, and NMAP, which is what we're using next. We're going to be using NetScan Tools, but not for a couple more weeks. But these are the three we're going to be using right away. And then if you don't already, from a previous class or for some reason, have the Project Management Book of Knowledge, the PMBOK, in your playlist, then go get that. This is the standard for project management, because we have a way of talking about things. We have our own nomenclature, we have our own acronyms, but other people that we need to work with as a part of our cybersecurity work speak about things differently. If we're penetration testing, we're trying to talk to somebody about something that's a problem, say with the AC or with the doors or locks or something like that. There's a way we need to be able to organize information and work with other players who also have a stake in a project. And we're going to be not reading the whole PMBOK, but we're going to be looking at a couple of sections of the PMBOK to help us get in the mindset and be able to understand why we do things a certain way when we're doing assessing assets, when we're doing assessing risk, when we're doing deciding on mitigations, and then when we're creating our plan to implement, because we don't just run around dropping, you know, turning dials and, you know, permitting this and denying that without a plan. So working with other people, project management book of knowledge is a very important thing. As a matter of fact, project management certification is an extremely valuable one. An awful lot of people would rather have you have a project management certification than worry about you being a CCNA, because you're going to be working as part of a team of a lot of different kinds of people, and the ability to organize and manage a project, that's a very valuable thing. So here is, I checked books for Project Management Book of Knowledge, PMBOK, and I believe the latest version is the fifth version, so that's where I'm going to add that to my playlist. Do I already have it in there? Yes, I do, actually. So you should have that in there. And so you've got those two things to do in the channel and the tests, and then the PMBOK. If you want to get a head start, then read Chapter 11 in the PMBOK, because that's going to be an assigned section in the next week. So I wanted to mention, I've got it in here to mention, Jesse Varsalone, who's written and participated in a number of really good books. He was one of my first instructors in cybersecurity. Very cool guy, and got some good books on his name. I just always remember him always referring to stuff that's easy to break in as like a Fisher-Price firewall. If you've ever seen one of those, I actually had one of those for a while, just as a demo. They're little plugins, and it would take kids to just one particular website without them being able to go anywhere else. A Fisher-Price firewall, that's an easy one to break into. So make sure, if you screwed something up or you didn't get it in there, you made a mistake, through into the semester, you know, put it in the original location on Canvas. It'll be regraded as new when I go through and do the next pass. So always keep in mind, a pro hint, for all the software we're putting here, make sure to use it, install it for all users, and install it using an administrative login so that it then is fully available and fully operational. That's especially important on Windows machines. We're going to be using Nmap very soon. Make sure you've got that going. And there's some Nmap PDFs there. Well, they're going to be in week 8. In Playbook. CMAP tools, again, get that in there, give it a try, play around with it. Then the how-to video playlist contains that how-to video on installing all three of those things. So that's free at gantproject.biz. Give it, you know, take it for a spin. And we're going to be creating a timeline later on, because that's one of the things that we need to do as part of planning for penetration testing, for instance. What are the steps we need to do? What are things that are interdependent? I need to finish this before we can do that. I need to get information that's generated with this step before I can do that one. Or what kinds of things can operate simultaneously and they're not interdependent? That's what a timeline is for. There's an example chart in there, and I think this is talked about in that how-to video, that, well, just like everybody knows how to build a house, right? You've got to plan it first where you can start digging a hole, and then you've got to have a foundation before you can start, putting a roof on. But then other things can happen at the same time. Once you sort of get started, there's some things that can happen simultaneously, and then there's some things that are interdependent or time dependent. Now, in more complex in management of a project, then we're going to be managing resources. We've got people, we've got trucks, we've got lumber, we've got, sheetrock, we've got, getting it here, getting it there in time, getting it ordered, all those sort of things. That's where, in a more complex situation, that's where we start to be able to have stuff actually work. Although our approach to this is going to be very simple and straightforward, just giving you a little taste of it. Okay, so what's the bottom line? Well, got anything to fix up? Put it in, but don't wait till finals week because there's going to be stuff to do in finals week. So don't wait till finals week to try to fix up stuff that was a mistake early on. As usual, watch all the videos, the to-do, getting ready, those installations, and then the two, not A, not AMC, ACM. Video trainings that I pointed you to, take the tests and post, do the 13th. So that's really it, short, sweet, and complete. Got two trainings to do in ACM. You've got to make sure you're doing your heads up with getting those pieces of software installed and running. And again, heads up, get the PMBOK bookmarked, read chapter 11 to get ahead, and we'll see you on the net.